So hello and greetings to the all the viewers. Today we will going to discuss about induction furnace introduction, advantages, construction, working principle and induction casting process flow. So we will start now. So this slide represents this introduction to the induction furnace. So induction heating is the process of heating an electrically conducting object, usually metals, by electromagnetic induction through the heat generated in the object using AC currents. Induction heating is the process of non-contact form of heating. So induction furnace capacity ranges from less than 1 kg to 100 tons and are used to melt the iron, steel, copper, as well as aluminum. The operating frequency ranges from utility frequency of 50 to 60 Hz to 400 kHz or higher, usually depends on the material being melted, the capacity or a volume of the furnace, as well as the melting speed required. So this slide represents the induction heating phenomena. So principle of induction heating is mainly based on two important well-known parameters or phenomena. First is electromagnetic induction. The energy transfer to the object to be heated occurs by means of electromagnetic induction. Any electrically conductive material placed in a variable magnetic field in the site of it will induce the electric current, which is called as a AC current, which will eventually lead to the Joule heating. And the second parameter is Joule heating effect. So the Joule heating, also known as ohmic heating and resistive heating, is the process by which the passage of an electric current through a conductor releases heat. So this slide represents the major advantages of induction furnace. It is very clean, less pollutant, energy efficient, as well as well controllable melting process when we compared the other means of melting methods. Now we'll discuss about the working principle of induction furnace. So this is nothing but your body of a furnace, which may consist of crucible with refractory lining. It may also consist of primary winding copper coils. So this schematic represents the construction of induction furnace. So if you see, it may consist of crucible body of a furnace, which is wounded by the copper coils. Inside this copper coils, cold water will going to flow. So here the frequency of a supply is very high. The skin effect in the primary coil increases the effective resistance in the coil, and hence the copper losses tends to be high. An additional cooling is necessary to reduce this copper losses. So that's why the coil is therefore made of hollow sections through which cooling water will going to flow. Now the workpieces are inserted inside the crucible, and these primary coils are connected to the high frequency AC source. So due to which the flux will going to be produced inside the primary coils, which may induces the AC current in the charge, which flow concentrically in the primary winding. So if you see, this is nothing but the AC current which will going to develop due to the magnetic field generated by the primary coil current flow. So this current heats up the charge to the melting point and provides steering actions to the charge. So if you see, due to this eddy current, the workpieces are melted up to the melting point and your metal will going to change the phase. Okay. So once the molten metal high frequency magnetic field is generated, it can also be used to steer the hot metal, which is useful in ensuring that alloying conditions are fully mixed in the melt. Okay. So now we will discuss about the process flow in an induction casting industries. So this is what the scrap which is used for a induction furnace as a raw material. So this is what the schematic of an induction furnace. So you can see this is what the molding process. After the mold is created, it is heated to for a pouring process. So once your heating or everything is done, your mold is ready for a pouring. Once after the magnetic field is generated, the metal will change its phase and it will be in a liquid form, which can be used to pour through these molds in order to generate the work pieces. So once your pouring is done, the cooling process will take place. So the induction heating will take place nearly 1 hour of time for this kind of configuration, and cooling will take place nearly 24 hours of a time. So this is what your induction casting process. So thank you guys. Thank you for your time.